Hello, my friends. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you step by step how to paint a landscape with palm trees. So, let's begin. I'm using a Prismacolor 902 Ultramarine. I am sketching the elements for my future landscape. I'm not going to put too many details at this stage, because later on it will be covered with color. But I just want a reference where the land and where my palm trees are going to be. I have to pay a little bit more attention when it comes to reflection, because they need to match. The next step, step number two, is to place the undertone. And for this, I'm going to alternate the color 929 pink, 1008 Parma violet, and 994, it's a process red. This will give me the background that I need for the sky. I am not using pressure at all, I'm just applying a thin layer of color. Using ultramarine again, I'm going to define the horizon line. This time I'm gonna work on both sides, on the sky and on the reflection, and I'm going to put more pressure than the usual. I'm going to alternate the blues with the pink, and then I'm going to put on top of it the color 995. It's a mulberry, it's a dark purple. I want to create a soft transition in between the pink and the blue. When I'm sketching the clouds, I'm not gonna put too many details. Actually, I'm not gonna put details in any of the steps, because this is a preliminary step. I'm just preparing and I'm adding the base that I need later on to put a beautiful sky. I'm using again the pink, the violet that I used before, and the final step will be to use the color 938, a white, and this will help me to blend the purples and the pink and to create the soft transition in between the colors. What I'm doing right now has a dual purpose. As I mentioned before, it gives me the undertone for the future painting. This is a painting, and later on I'm going to use acrylic color. But because right now I'm using paper as a support, and I need to protect the paper. So for this reason, I preferred the first layer to be the color pencil to create the sealing that I need, so the water will not damage the paper too much. Also, I'm trying to apply a layer of ultramarine, and I'm trying to finish the lake by applying a uniform color of blue and blend it. And now we're ready to move on to the next step, which is painting. So, I'm using my favorite brush, which is the small fine detail brush. I loaded with cobalt blue and titanium white, and I am painting the clouds. Now, here I would like to share with you my favorite technique when it comes to painting clouds. I prefer to use transparent layering, and I like to do layers on top of layers on top of layers, and in this way I can achieve the puffiness and the texture of the cloud. So as you can see, When we paint clouds, there is no specific shape, and each individual cloud is unique. We can still see the pink-purple background that I did before using color pencil. I'm going to change that. I'm going to keep only the areas that I like, the ones that look good, the one that I'm happy with, and what I don't like, I'm going to cover with painting. And I'm also doing little touch-ups, and I'm trying to adjust the shape for the clouds. Right now I'm using a layer of transparent white, just simple white, and I'm covering those areas that I don't like too much. And also I'm trying to blend it and to spread it all over so it doesn't look like something artificial on top. I want to give that natural look. I'm going here for a realistic painting, and I'm trying to blend the edges of the cloud to go smoother and as nice as possible. Also, I am applying highlights on the cloud. Where the light hits the cloud, there it has a little bit of highlight and bright color. For the land, I'm going to mix the cobalt blue with a little bit of black. Even if here it looks dark and it looks that it's almost a black, it will be too strong to use just black. That's why I prefer to mix it with blue. So straight on, I'm going to paint the land. At the final part of our painting, which is the palm trees. For this, I'm going to use the traces from the drawing that I did before. It is not very obvious, but it's enough so it gives me a clue where to place my trees. For this, what I'm trying to do, first of all, is to avoid drawing the threes as a straight stick. That's why I'm trying to bend them, to make them crooked, to give them some sort of dynamics. And also, I am trying to place the trees in groups of two, of three, to give them a little bit of a story behind them. For the leaves, I'm going to use only the tip of my brush. And I'm going to start off first by drawing a star. And then for each of the main branches, I'm going to draw that little leaves that looks like needle. Here it's lots of details to be put on each individual branch, each individual leaf. But once you start it, you're gonna notice that it's not very difficult and it's very pleasant. When we draw the shape for the crown, We're gonna use short branches, long branches, so we don't create equality, and that way our tree looks more natural. And also when it comes to the leaves, again, there are short leaves, long ones, bent ones, straight ones, all sorts. More dynamic, more diverse, and looks more beautiful. This started with a thought that I have about a tropical vacation. And I was imagining an island surrounded by water, a place where you can admire beautiful sunset and you can hear the waves, and a place with lots of palm trees. And that was my first thought. And then I said, it would be beautiful to put it on a paper. And now, as I am painting the palm trees, I want to encourage you to go after the thing that you are dreaming. Even if at the beginning it seems challenging, or sometimes it looks difficult, and sometimes you can say, you know what, it's easier not to do it. Once you start doing it, you will discover a big surprise. Even if sometimes you feel overwhelmed, just the idea of doing something that you like, something that you dream and you're passionate of, that will give you energy. It will carry on to do it. I never thought that I'm gonna do palm trees, but as I'm doing it, I am really, really enjoying it. And I imagine myself being there. And that's the beauty of art. There is no limitation, and you can reach anything that you want through imagination. You can travel anywhere, and it can be anything. As I am painting the crown, I am overlapping some leaves, and that will create some areas where the color is darker and some where it's lighter, and that creates more of a natural look to my palm trees. I looked a little bit to pictures with palm trees, and I'm trying to get as close as possible to a realistic look, where I see that it needs a little bit of dark. I'm going to apply more color. The rest, I'm going to apply just light strokes and short needles in all the direction, and I will try to go in multiple layers to create that realistic look of palm trees, something that it's naturally beautiful. And the last part for this painting, it's the reflection. I'm not going to put too much detail, and I'm going to deliberately make it more unfinished, because the image that is reflected, it's a little bit distorted from the reality, and I'm not going to put too many details into the reflection, but I'm going to still keep the major shape, the star shape that the crown for the tree have. When it comes to the color, I'm going to use the same color as the trees, but I'm going to make it more fluid color and more transparent. It's just, if you want, it's more of a suggestion of something. And this is my sunset with palm trees. I hope you liked the video as much as I did sharing it with you. I'm looking forward to know what is your favorite thing to paint. Please visit my website at mgartgallery.com. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.